Hi everyone. So here we are today with the Galaxy S3 running Android 4.2.2. Why is that important? Well, as you may know, the Galaxy S4 launched with Android 4.2.2, the latest version of Google Android's Jelly Bean. So what we have now is the Galaxy S3 that is quite a bit closer in kind of functionality to the Galaxy S4. They haven't ported across a lot of the apps yet. No idea if they will at this point, but what they have done is incorporated quite a lot of the Android Jelly Bean 4.2.2 features. I'm going to stop saying that now. But here's basically what we've got. The notification area has been given a redesign, including all of the quick settings widgets at the top. You also now have the notification area drop down for the settings widget there, which makes it really quick and easy to rearrange them or turn all of them on and off. It's the notification panel. They've also completely overhauled the settings area, which now works exactly like the Galaxy S4. So everything is now split down into these four core areas across the top and then more information underneath. So if you go into connections, you've got your access to your Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, data usage, networks. You can now turn NFC and the S-Beam features off, on and off, directly from the connections area. It's not in a sub-menu any longer. Nearby devices, screen mirroring and keys is also in there. Basically anything connections related. In my device, this very much deals with personalization. So you've got your lock screen area, which we'll come onto in a moment, which also now includes the lock screen widgets. Yes! Absolutely fantastic to finally have that, because there's so much extra functionality we can add to our phones when we can add widgets directly onto the lock screen, but we'll take a look at that in a minute. So you've now got all of those options in there. The multi-window and notification panel that you can turn on and off, we saw that a moment ago. You can also do multi-window support as well, which is the slide-outs. That's from previous versions. That actually came across in the Note 2, but it's still there if you enjoy using it. You've got the screen mode, which now has adapt display technology built in. So with the Galaxy S4, they launched a new software tweak, as it were, which allowed the display to, well, the device to sense the content that you were looking at and then adapt the display brightness and colours accordingly. You can turn that on or off or put it back onto dynamic if you like. Let's leave it on there. Daydream is included. I haven't had a good chance to play with that yet, but it looks pretty cool. And also a few other bits and pieces. Your fonts are in there as well. LED indicators, sound, home screen mode if you want to switch it into easy mode for those people that want to or do. Call, your blocking, a driving mode is included, power saving, accessories. Wow, there's plenty in here. Motion, smart screen and voice control. So let's have a quick look at smart screen. Yeah, they've not incorporated all of the functionality from the S4 here. It's still just the same items we had previously. Motion controls are likewise, I think, the same. In accounts, this is really probably the best change that Samsung have made here. They've moved accounts rather than having it jammed somewhere else. It's now out on its own, and you can quickly and easily see what all your accounts are and interact with them if you need to. In more, this is where they've kind of put all the useful tools, really. You've got your application manager for installing and, sorry, for uninstalling applications and seeing what's taking up space. Battery, for seeing what's chewing up your battery the most. My screen, usually. Storage space, date and time, and about device. And if you need to, you pop it into developer mode, just like that. There's your developer options, should you need them. So that's the settings. Now, okay, so let's take a look at the widgets on the lock screen, because this is probably the coolest feature they've added. So all you need to do, where it says the Life Companion, if you drag there, you can flick over to the various widgets. Now, if you keep going, you'll find one with a plus symbol, and you can then add one of your widgets. Just add my SSH. And you can see there, I've now got widgets on my lock screen and working beautifully. It gives you a lot more control of your Galaxy S3 without having to go all the way into the device. And you can see there, I can fire up my camera if I want to. Back out and drops me into my home screen Very, very nice. Overall, it's nice to see Samsung keeping pace with the Galaxy S4 and at least backporting some of the features and, more importantly, improving the S3's usability as well. Certainly these changes to the settings area are absolutely fantastic. They were great on the S4 and to now have them ported across to the S3 as well is great. Obviously, we can expect to see these on the Note 2 as well. I doubt very much Samsung will leave the Note 2 out of these changes. It makes sense. Absolutely fantastic. If you want to try this update out, it's not final software, it hasn't got any warranty. You can get it from sammobile.com, do a Google search. Download it, run Odin, flash away, and you can be running it as well. Like I say, forget your warranty if you do this or anything like that. It is incrementing your binary counter as well. So do it at your own risk, basically. But from what I can see so far, there's a few little strange bugs here or there, but it's looking pretty good. Some great new features, absolutely fantastic. Yeah.